Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So I am back with a weekly grocery haul. I know the last few videos I've posted on my channel have been 2 week grocery hauls, but honestly, I think I wanna get back to the weekly grocery hauls just because I haven't been like super organized with the 2 week ones, and like my fridge has been kind of a big mess. And because I have to store like a lot of food in there. I like kind of the simplicity of the weekly grocery hauls because I get basically exactly what I need. The food is pretty fresh, you know, will last the week, and then I stock up again on Monday. Cheese. You pick up your apple, bud. It's on the floor right there. These babies have been huge fans. Let me see the fishing pole. We got them these little fishing poles, and they just, it's like they're little teddy bears. They just walk around the house, and they go fishing inside the house, which there's no like line on it really. I mean, I think there's a line, but there's no like hook or anything, but I don't know, they love fishing, it's super cute. So anyway, so I'm gonna try to get back to the weekly grocery hauls. And just like that, it's nap time. I was about 20 seconds into showing you guys the groceries, and they were showing me very obvious signs that it was time for a nap. So put them down for a nap so they're good to go. So starting off back here, I got 2 gallons of milk and then some almond milk. The almond milk, I buy this like green powder that it's like, it's supposed to have all these extra nutrients and you know, all that stuff. And so you mix it with some almond milk. So need some almond milk for that. And I also saw a recipe for Wendy's Copycat Frosties, and you need some almond milk. So figured I'd go ahead and just get some of that. Also 1 bag of apples. Again, this is only for a week, so I think we should be good with that. Bunch of bananas. Again, some of these are gonna be for the Wendy's little milkshakes and then like smoothies and stuff. Some romaine lettuce for just all sorts of stuff. Sandwiches and salads and wraps and all that. Some baby carrots. So I typically buy just the regular carrots, but then I have to like clean them and strip them and cut them and chop them and all that stuff. So I thought that I would just save myself all of that and buy the kind that's already ready to go. Just rinse them off and feed them to everybody. Also got some turkey breast for some sandwiches, and then also some hard salami because hard salami is awesome. And then some French bread to go with like sandwiches and stuff, and the whole wheat bread for sandwiches as well. I'm fine with like the regular sandwich bread, but you guys, I love French bread. Also, it'll act as some, I'm pretty sure that we have some garlic bread in the freezer, but in case I need to make like some garlic bread for a side for dinners or toast or something, have some French bread for that. Also got a whole bunch of yogurt. So Connor really likes the vanilla yogurt. He says it tastes like ice cream. So I got 2 of those, and then some mixed berry down there at the bottom, and then 2 of these yogurt tubes. So I think it comes with 8, so 16 total. So I'm just gonna stick both of these boxes in the freezer because all of the boys really like eating the frozen yogurt. So I guess it kind of reminds them of ice cream. So for Sunday dessert this week, we're gonna have iced brownies. So just a box of brownies right there, and then a container of icing. We'll use half of that icing to frost the brownies after I cook them. I did that last weekend or the weekend before, and it was just really good. It was a big hit. Everyone really liked it. So figured we'd do that again. And I have a whole bunch of Halloween sprinkles that we can decorate those with. Also gonna have wings this week. So I got some Italian dressing to marinate those with. So what I typically do, because I get the wings at Costco, I'll put them in a freezer bag when they're still frozen. And then I'll put an entire bottle of the Italian dressing in there and just stick it in the fridge. It thaws out overnight, and then we'll just put them on the grill the next day, and they work out really great. I have the buffalo sauce already on hand, and we have like tater tots or french fries or whatever we want to go with that. So wings 1 day this week. Also, we're gonna have some burrito bowls. So I got some pinto beans for that. I just realized I don't think I need the taco seasoning because I am making some chipotle copycat of the barbacoa. So I got a whole bunch of my roasts that were on sale recently, so I have a bunch in the freezer. So I've made this before where you take the roast and you basically, it's the recipe is supposed to mimic barbacoa from Chipotle. I already said that, but basically you just add all these ingredients together and you cook it in the crock pot. I've made it before, it's really good. It's pretty similar to that recipe. So for the burrito bowls this week, we're gonna have the barbacoa. So I usually get the taco seasoning. I think I was just on autopilot. That's not a big deal. That'll just live in the pantry. But I usually use the taco seasoning for chicken or ground beef. But again, I'm gonna do the barbacoa this week. So sorry, you need some apple cider vinegar for that. You also need some lime juice. And then some of these chipotle peppers. And then I needed some ground cumin. I was completely out, so I got some of that. And then the recipe, there's a few other ingredients that I have on hand, but that's all I needed from the store. I will link that down below if you guys wanna try it. Again, I've made it before and it was really good. And it makes a bunch, so we freeze it and we can have it for like nachos or tacos or whatever. Pretty good. Also gonna make some pico de gallo to go with that. So I got some tomatoes. I also got some jalapenos, a red onion, and a bunch of cilantro. So the cilantro is going to be for the pico de gallo, as well as the cilantro lime rice that I make for the burrito bowls, as well as this container of the lime juice. I typically just buy limes and then just juice them myself, but the last few limes I've gotten have been like super tiny, not a lot of juice, so I figured I would just get a bottle of juice and see how that works. We're also gonna have chicken burgers this week, so I have some chicken patties in the freezer that I have left over from last week. I just need the hamburger buns. I also have tater tots and whatnot. I did go to the grocery store last week, but I just didn't film it. It wasn't happening for us last week. This is something I'm really excited about. So, because I was being naughty, I just typed in for the grocery pickup cheesecake because I just wanted to see what they had. And the Cheesecake Factory sells individual slices of cheesecake. So I'm pretty sure I've seen before that Walmart sells like a big cheesecake from the Cheesecake Factory with the different flavors, but it's like 16 bucks or something like that. This one, I mean, it's only like 2 bites. It's super teeny tiny, but it's like $2 and something cents, whatever. But I just saw that and I was like, ah, add to cart. I have to. I just want it. So grab that just for something fun. Also got some chips to go with some sandwiches, some tortilla chips. Those go with the burrito bowls and then just like snacking and whatnot. Needed some more dishwashing detergent. I'm running kind of low, so just have that for whenever I need it. Got some diapers. And then also I got some stuff to make some chicken tetrazzini. So I got a whole bunch of spaghetti noodles. I've mentioned this a few times from my mother-in-law. But I'm sick of spaghetti. So I was looking up other recipes that I could make just easily with those spaghetti noodles. And this one came up. So I have the chicken breast in the freezer. I don't need that. I have the chicken broth as well. So I only needed some sour cream. This is a pretty big container. So I'm also gonna use this for the burrito bowls. And then you need like 2 cups of sour cream, 2 cans of cream of chicken soup, some mozzarella cheese, and Parmesan cheese, which I have. So not a healthy dish by any means, super heavy, but again, I thought it would be a good dish to make sometime this week. And I'm sure everyone will really enjoy it. We'll serve it with a side salad. Also over here, I got Matt some more of his little Lunchable type things. So some salami and some extra sharp cheese. I just cut this into like slivers like this and then cut those in half to make little squares. And he'll just add those to the salami and he'll have that for lunch. I also mentioned that I went to the store last week and I didn't film that grocery haul, but while we were there, Matt picked up a few boxes of these Triscuit crackers, I think roasted garlic and maybe a few other flavors. So we have those from that grocery trip last week that he will be eating with the salami and the cheese. And then I have stuff from Costco that I send with him, like trail mix, and I'll send a banana or an apple or something like that. But again, that's the haul for this week. So as always, my meal plan is gonna be listed down below. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.